Hi friends, Miss Stephanie here with another First Chapter Friday. Today's first chapter is going to come from the book The Hedgehog of Oz, written by Corey Leonardo. And instead of the first chapter, we're going to read what's called the overture of this book. Here we go, The Hedgehog of Oz, overture. Tucked between a brick apartment building and a busy corner deli, on a storybook tree-lined street sits a theater, a run-down but beautiful theater. At precisely 6 o'clock every morning, a long ladder pushes through the shiny front entrance with a wrench and a terrible screech. The ladder unfolds. Under the cheerful glow of the marquee, an elderly man ascends. One by one, letters are plucked from beneath the now showing sign and scooted around. Attack of the Atomic Alien Cats becomes Night of a Thousand Kisses in the Bat of an Eyelash. Though the marquee might read, Marigold Takes Manhattan at 6 a.m., by 6:05, Bleak Battle 3 will blaze in its stead, lit up by the 100 globe lights that hug the edge of the great sign and wink on the cracked tiles below. A ticket booth, all glass and gold trim, stands waiting between two sets of doors, ready to collect dollar bills, coins, traces of pocket lint. And every evening, tickets in hand, the moviegoers file in with anticipation. Past the doors, into the lobby, through the warm, inviting balm of the buttery popcorn air. A line forms at the snack counter. Orange fizzy pop and crystal cola sloshes into tall cups of ice. Popcorn pops in an old-fashioned popcorn cart and spills into greasy buckets. Stray kernels crunch into the carpets below. The cash register chimes as a woman in blue orders chocolate buttons and gummy fruit gems, while a gaggle of small boys presses noses and sticky fingers to the smudged glass. They ogle long ropes of licorice and lollipops the size of their heads. A pair of elderly gentlemen order the same confection selections, cocoa nutties, toffee beans, and cinnamon snaps, three boxes each. Gumdrops, peppermints, caramels so sticky they can't be carved away from your teeth for a week. The register sings and sings and sings. Past the concession stand, deep inside and so high it seems pinned to the clouds painted on the peeling ceiling, a heavy curtain cascades to the stage and pools in great crimson tufts. It harbors more than a few moth-eaten holes. And though it's a bit worn now in places, the theater's proud gold paint brightens the baseboard, the balcony, the flying monkeys spiraling up pillars to the opera seats, a cornice of poppies crowning the stage. Emerald City murals, chipped and faded over the years, glow from the wings, while the theater's threadbare velvet seats warm under the sparkle of diamond chandeliers. All is hushed. Everything waits. Crash! Clonk! The lobby doors open. People stroll down the aisles and plunk themselves into seats, two here, three over there. Chandeliers dim as tiny glass bulbs bordering the aisles flicker to life, lighting the way for more napkins, a splash of soda, a second bag of licorice. The music strikes its first chord. Voices hush. The curtain rises and the show goes on. The theater's heart beats differently every night. The screen might conjure a laugh, a gasp, even an infrequent snore. A sob might bubble up and float into the laughters. Squeals of fright, peals of delight. It's just like this that the months and years of the Emerald City Theater have marched on. And from gleam and sheen to wear and tear, the decades slowly drifted by. There is one thing, however, that has always remained the same. Every Saturday at noon sharp, there plays one matinee show. The film hasn't changed. The same movie reel clicks away every Saturday and has for as long as anyone can remember the doors being opened. And lately, something else too. A pair of eyes has been glued to the noon matinee each week. A pair of eyes behind much too large eyeglasses. Kansas, flying houses, a group of travelers on the yellow brick road. Every Saturday, high in the theater's sagging balcony, now closed off and cobwebbed with time and disuse, a bespectacled Marcel perches on the back of a dusty theater chair, taking it all in. The Wicked Witch cackling and the film reel crackling. Those ruby slippers and no place like home. Marcel knows every word of Over the Rainbow. He's sung it before, probably 1,000 times. Well, before. Before he came to the theater, that is. Once upon a time. He hasn't sung a note of it since. For a while, as the first violin notes quivered to life and his beloved movie picture lit up the screen, he could imagine it, though. A reunion. One fit for the movies. A happily ever after. Maybe she'd seen the marquee. Maybe, with a hitch in her heart and Marcel in her mind, she'd decide to take in the show, their show, one more time. And for a while he'd watch, not the matinee, but for that glimpse of braids, the flash of braces, a sticker-covered skateboard. For a long time, months even, a glimmer of hope remained. But she never came. And now? Well, Auntie Hen might perch beside him. And when she's not pecking at a popcorn kernel or the sticky remains of a lemon drop, Uncle Henrietta will sit for a few. Two fat hens roosting in the balcony above the dark theater watching The Wizard of Oz. And Marcel, that Oz-loving hedgehog? Yes, he watches too. And that's the overture for this first chapter Friday of The Hedgehog of Oz. Find out what happens next, you'll have to check this out from the Laudit Library. Take care, and I'll be back again soon with another First Chapter Friday. Bye!